Hey beauties, and welcome to this booty builder workout. What you guys will need is a resistance band. It doesn't matter if it has more resistance or not, it's whatever you guys feel comfortable with. So I have my resistance band here, and let's get into the workout. For the first booty workout, these ones are called banded walks. I'm sure you guys have all done these before, or have seen them, or have come across them. What you guys are going to do is you're going to take your band, you are going to keep it right above your ankle. So you're going to get in it, you're going to work it down, place it there, and once you have a good placement and you feel comfortable, sometimes they roll up. The resistance bands, it's normal, don't worry, just fix it. If that happens in between your workouts, just take a second, pause, fix the resistance band, and get back into it. Banded walks. So once you have the resistance band by your ankles, you are going to start on one side of your mat or one side of the room or wherever you might be. We are going to start in a squatting position, not super low, not super high, somewhere right in between. You are going to meet your outside leg, whichever leg is on the outside. So if I'm starting with my right side, my outside leg is going to be my left. If I'm starting with the left, my outside leg will be my right. So once I have my position and I know what leg I want to start with, I just start walking. I step out and in, out and in, out and in. You want there to still be resistance in your band. You don't want to come so far in where you don't feel like there's a band in your legs and where it becomes loose and then falls down. You want to be able to have resistance. You want to be able to feel that. That's the whole point as to why we're using a resistance band. So once you get to one side, you're going to do the same thing on the other. Step out, in, out, in, out, in. You're going to feel it in your booty. You're going to feel it in your quads. If you do, and if you feel like you literally have to take a break, please do so. Come back up, relax for a second, and get right back into it. These are called banded walks, and it should look something like this. Good job, guys, and off to booty exercise number two. So you are going to keep your resistance band in the same area as to how it was for the first one, for the banded walks. But this time, instead of being on our feet, we are going to be on our side. So I will lay on my right side. I'm going to have my arm down to stabilize me, and I'm going to have my legs completely together, and I'm gonna look like I am in one line. I'm going to have to fix my resistance band because it does get tangled and I am sweaty, so it does get a little harder. You're going to lay down, keep your legs together, and I want that top leg. So for me, it's my left. I want your top leg to kind of float over your bottom. I want it to feel like you are already gaining the hardest booty workout of your life. Because to keep your leg up and to not relax it down is hard. That's a workout within itself. But we're gonna add little kick-ups. These are called sideline abductions, but I like to also kind of, when I'm working out, call them kick-ups, because what you're doing is you're kicking up, up, up. And I want you to rotate your knee in rather than out, because if your knee is rotating out, this is not gonna do it. You're putting the pressure in your hips rather than in your butt, and tomorrow morning you will be really sore in your hips and not in your booty, and we don't want that. We want our booty to be looking good. We wanna have that curve underneath it. So for to be able to see that progress, you need to be able to do the workout correctly. So hover over your leg, rotate in, put your hand down if you need to be stable. If you need more stabilization, that's okay. If not, you can just keep it on your hip. I like to keep it here only so that I know I'm doing the workout correctly. So once I have this position, I can start to just kick up. Side lying abductions, you guys will thank me later. I'm already feeling it in my booty. Once you feel like you've done enough on this side, you may switch over and do it on the other. Off to booty exercise number three. So, booty exercise number three. These ones are called glute bridges with pulse. So how we're gonna do this is we're gonna be laying on our back. Our band does not move. It stays in the same place for exercise number one, two, and three. You're going to keep our legs planted on the floor. You're going to lay down, get a nice little rest in before you start this exercise. You're going to take your hands, put them behind your neck. You're going to keep your legs apart so you feel the resistance. You're going to bring your booty up, glute bridge. You're going to create a bridge. And you are going to pulse, pulse, pulse. We are not bringing our booty down and up. These are not the full extension booty glute bridge. These are just pulses. So we are going to come up. We are going to feel our butt contract. If you don't, please squeeze your booties. Squeeze them, squeeze them, squeeze them, like you're juicing two lemons. I know it sounds funny, but I really do mean it. So once you're up and once your legs are out, I want you to keep your hands in a prayer position, bring it to your chest, and I want you to pulse up, pulse up, pulse up. Hold it for a second. Once you get up, go back down and pulse, pulse, pulse.
I'm all good already, so moved on, it's scary. I'm not where you left me at all, so.
And those are called glute bridges and pulses. Off to the last booty exercise. You guys are almost there and doing an amazing job. These ones are called squat to leg extensions. You will only need your body weight. You can take your resistant band and kiss it goodbye because we do not need it anymore. Okay, so what we are going to do is we are going to get in a squat position. However you feel comfortable doing your squats, that's how it's going to be. You're gonna get in your squat position, make sure your knees aren't facing out. These are not sumo squats, these are regular squats. So you're going to squat, come up. I'm gonna start with my right leg, extend, come back in. Squat, up, extend, down. Up, extend. And you guys might be questioning as to like, what is the extension doing? I will show you from sideways. Pay attention to my booty and look what it does when I kick out. Watch. Did you guys see that? It contracted. My booty contracted super tightly. So you go down, up, lean to your right side. That's how you're gonna be stabilized. You're using your right leg and you're gonna come up. You should feel it not only in your booty, but also in your side. Up. Down, up, and then you'll do it on the other side. So I'll switch on this side so you guys can see this leg as well. Down, up, extend, place it back down. Again, down, up, extend. So if I'm facing the camera, this is how it should look.
So if you don't wanna see me dancing with somebody,
guys, you guys did an amazing job with this booty builder workout. You guys did it. How do you feel? I feel amazing. I feel like I need to go take a shower or even jump in that pool. I am super sweaty and I am so happy I got to do it with you guys. I love you so much and I can't wait to work out with you guys again. Mwah.